Oh, welcome to another little video on phi mapping. Let's see if we can try and understand this beetle a little bit. Jewel beetle, fantastic photograph. Wish I knew who took it. Was not me. These are a bunch of the shapes that we have at our disposal, but these are the ones that we're going to basically use. I'll just focus on these for a little bit this time. And try and start with a rectangle. See if we can find our primary phi area. Which is not quite that. Seems more reasonable that it's at least something like that, which from the length of that main part of the body basically to the ground here a little bit is about a phi rectangle. And these are centered, these are phi scales of each other centered, so you can see that's a phi scale in there. Okay, interesting. Okay, let's try with these circles, reflecting a more of a square pattern, but still doing the phi relationships. And if we maintain that and go to the ground, from the back to basically the ground, let's try this one. Basically the whole back part of the body there. There's something. scale it down one scale. Let's try the thigh spiral. Does that part okay? Especially this line back here. So really, if it was like that, if that was also 1/5 scale smaller, not the same shape, but it's the same division almost, or it's a very similar division. Nice. Let's try actually with the one of these just area squares. You can see at this scale, we've got this line here going back, articulating this top shell part, and then this line here also right along the bottom. So that's definitely phi relationship there. Major axis right on the leg. That's the center point. Almost putting this crosshair right there. Check out that foot actually. Again, that scaled that whole length of the leg there. Almost all of the legs in some rough iteration. It's the same as this, just a little bit minus the head, so the whatever part sticks out there, and then that should be about as big as the body. Just free scale here for a second. It's almost articulating those two points, not quite. It'd have to be a little bit bigger. So we get this line and this line right on those two lines. I think. Kind of just to be like that to the end of the claw, just does that okay, then starts to lose some other aspects, but anyway, anywho. Feet are quite an interesting shape. Yes, let's try this one. More of a linear spiral will give us similar but slightly different information than the curved spiral. the inverse of the phi spiral. It's pretty close to actually just a full phi rectangle. It's nice having that one right on the leg like that, though. If we went to the whole thing, literally as far as it could possibly go, Right, let's try this circle pattern. The phi spiral. What's the difference between a sequence and a pattern? Exactly that shape. Try the from the Fibonacci pattern. sequence, whichever you like. It's a sequence which then creates a pattern. And this one. Okay. I mean, we certainly could take some of these, like, for example, this one is a pretty major rectangular harmony in the Phi sequence. Typically inherent in this one. So we go just take what is one that looks like it might fit. These sometimes work. Let's try this one. It's not such a clear rectangle here. It's just simply not going to do that shell. We're just going to chase it. But the relationship is not a total loss. I mean, there's clearly a bunch that's pretty major, that area. And this feet thing is marking something. Each of those lines is marking something. And that was this one. If we take the opposite of one of those, say, maybe this one. Yep, so there's going to be a bunch of those relationships in there. I believe that's basically a pretty quick intro to this beetle here. Lots of Phi harmonies for sure. And just a beautiful creature. Amazing. Thank you, folks. Hope you have a great day out there. Take care. Bye.